This is called an ILRIS 360, and what it is it's a LiDAR scanner.
While that's booting, I'll open up the software that controls it.
LiDAR is just like radar or sonar, except it uses laser light instead of sound or radio waves. Okay, and then we got about 30 seconds while it boots, 60 seconds while it boots. It's remarkably boring, actually. It's horribly boring. The best part is going in and out of this cool cave, really.
Every spring, millions of Mexican free-tailed bats migrate north to roosting sites in Texas. One of those sites is the Devil's Sinkhole State Natural Area, located about 100 miles west of San Antonio, near the town of Rock Springs. The Devil's Sinkhole isn't just a big hole in the ground. It's a perfect place for bats to raise their young. All summer long, the bats cling to the walls of the sinkhole, emerging each evening to search for food.
This was a flooded aquifer at one point, and the water was supporting probably about 40% of the weight of the roof. And then the water level probably dropped, so then the whole thing kind of collapsed down and formed this vertical shaft. So the bottom is about 300 to 400 feet below the surface.
The Mexican free-tail comes up here because we have caves in this area. It's a karst area, they call it, and it's like Swiss cheese.
You go out to the sinkhole, and it's impressive in itself, just looking down into it. And then when you see the bats come out, that's really, you know, really impressive as well. But you don't really get a feel for the real magnitude of it, or the fact that where you're standing underneath the ground is completely open to space. You know, you don't get the feel for that size. The, you know, the sheer magnitude of this hole is really impressive.
You don't want to be on the rock.
Because the Devil's Sinkhole is such a fragile and potentially dangerous environment, access is limited. The only way into the cave is by rappelling down 150 feet of rope.
Looking good.
This group of visitors is a special one, comprised of elite cavers, biologists, and geologists.
Radio slack.
Slack.
They've come to map the inside of the sinkhole using laser technology.
The thing that's really intriguing about this is that it's sort of like a giant case study where I can go look at the underground rock formations in three dimensions. I can walk around, you know, and look at the walls of the cave, and I can measure the thicknesses of the various beds and begin to put together sort of a vertical sequence of the history of Texas. The only thing better would be if you could actually walk through the walls. Then that would be even, you know, that'd be even better. As the mirror pans the laser back and forth, you get individual points that it records the XYZ position of each laser shot. And at the end of the day, you have a 3D point cloud of laser points.
Okay, let's start again. If you want to visit the sinkhole, your journey begins in Rock Springs at the Visitor Center, which is home to the Devil's Sinkhole Society. Here, you can watch a video about the sinkhole. Or look at photographs of the sinkhole. Or see maps of the sinkhole.
On belay, 1 and 2.
What you cannot do is drop into the sinkhole. And that's where the geologists with the lasers come in.
So the objective of what we're doing is we're shooting a laser model to recreate this space digitally, where we can show people what it's like to be at the bottom of this hole without having to drop down 150 foot on a piece of rope.
8.85.
The goal of the project is to produce a 3D virtual tour of the sinkhole. Visitors will be able to fly around like a bat or drop down a digital rope and see what the sinkhole is really like.
But it's a totally different view from the bottom. And this 3D image will allow us to essentially fly through the entire cave system without having to leave the ground.
Okay, you ready?
The laser is known as LIDAR. That stands for light, detection, and ranging.
Once it finds that position, then you can
set up a scan for whatever angle you want.
The technology has been around since the 1960s, and it's been used for tracking satellites, mapping mountains, and charting the ocean's floor.
It times how fast that laser travels from the box to the surface and back, divides that in two, multiplies by the speed of light, and you get a distance. And at the end of the day, you can reconstruct very accurately, down to the centimeter level, all the rock that you see here.
Ready?
Okay. In the traditional mapping method for caves, the mappers would go in with a tape measure and a compass.
15 foot, 5.5 inches.
And they'd literally measure this wide at this dimension, and they'd write down the number, and then they'd go to the next thing, and they'd measure. And it would take months to map a relatively small room.
70.5 degrees.
And really, in a matter of a few days, we were able to map the entire cave system at about a 1 centimeter point spacing. So it's extremely accurate.
The field work was the easy part of the project. Now, all that information collected by the LIDAR has to be entered into a computer. Since the information from the sinkhole is literally millions of points of data, the computer, in this case, is a bunch of computers, all tied together and working as one.
This has 256 processors, 256 times what a normal computer would have, and 256 gigabytes of memory, compared to a typical computer that might have 1, 2, or 4 gigabytes. A lot of power.
We're in a similar position here. You can see Devil's Sinkhole now, this little dark area. I'll zoom in on that right now. And it stands out quite nicely here. You see the white limestone rim around the edge, and the dark spot in the center is the sinkhole itself. You know, this project basically could never have even been done before we implemented this laser scanning technology. You just couldn't physically do it. There was no real good way to do it. And now we can do it in just a few days.
The Devil's Sinkhole Mapping Project will allow geologists to study layers of the Earth that often get overlooked. The park staff will be able to keep tabs on changes in the cave, and visitors to the sinkhole will be able to get a real feel of what it's like to be 300 feet down inside Texas.
This is an amazing project. For those folks who never get a chance to go down into it, they're going to get to view it as if they were going into it themselves.